Hello everyone, I'm Rupali Meshram. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for my latest updates. Good morning students. Today we are going to start with Geography, Standard 7th, Chapter 3, Tides. Can you tell? Observe the following picture and answer the questions given below and discuss. First question. Do the above photographs show the same places or different places? The answer is, the photographs in figure 3.1A and 3.1B shows the same place. Second question. Observe and note the spread of water seen in both the photographs. The answer is, in figure 3.1A, the spread of water is more as the water body is filled up to the rim, unlike figure 3.1b where the spread of water is comparatively less. Here the level of water has reduced and we can see a part of the land which was submerged in the water in figure 3.1b. Third question. What is this natural event called? Answer is, the natural event occurring in figure 3.1A is called as high tide, while in 3.1B the area is experiencing low tide. Geographical explanation. Both the photographs shows the same place if you stay near the coast for some time. You will realize that the sea water is sometimes very close to the coast, figure 3.1A, while at the other time it is far away from the coast, figure 3.1B. We call these movements of the seawater tides. Bearing a few exceptions, all the coasts on the earth experiences tides. High and low tides are natural phenomenon. Let us try to understand the scientific reason behind these natural events. Tides are movements of seawater occurring daily and regularly. The level of seawater changes after a specific period of time. After every 12 hours and 25 minutes, a cycle of high tide and low tide gets completed. This regularly occurring event appears to be quite simple and natural. However, it is directly related to the sun, the moon and the earth, and the gravitational and centrifugal forces that interact between them. Try this. Keep a small stone or a chalk piece on your notebook and move the notebook from left to right with some force. Take water in a small container which has a handle. See what happens if the container is filled around with force. While the mixer jars and water and switch on the mixer. Observe a fan and a slingshot while they are moving. Take half glass of water. Slowly move the glass in one direction, in circular fashion. Observe what happens to the water. Observe what happens if you will a key ring around a finger. Can you tell? In which direction did the piece of chalk fall? The answer is, the chalk fell in the left direction. Second question. Where did the water in the glass show a bulge? Answer is, the water in the glass showed a bulge towards the periphery, that is towards the edge of the glass. Third question. What effect did the movement have on the things attached to the key ring? Answer is, the things attached to the key ring move outward parallel to the ground and is in a circular motion about the finger. Fourth question. What happened to the water in the container and the mixer? The water moves and force when the container and the mixer are whirled around in a circular fashion. The water forms a small whirlpool inside the container and the mixer. Fifth question. Which forces could be operating in the activities listed above? The forces operating in the above activities are gravitational force, centrifugal force, oscillating force, etc. Question 6. In which activities did you find the centrifugal or the gravitational force was greater? Answer is, the gravitational force was initially greater in all the activities. However, as the object were brought into motion and their spread increase, the centrifugal force becomes greater than the gravitational force. Geographical explanation. In all the above activities, the effect of the centrifugal force is visible. The centrifugal force acts in the direction opposite to the gravitational force. Centrifugal means going away from the center. You must have experienced it too. At the local fairs, if you sit in a fairy's wheel, you sit spins and turns outward away from the wheel. This also is an effect of centrifugal force. Centrifugal and gravitational force. Due to its rotation, the earth gets a type of power or force. This force works away from the center. It is called centrifugal force. Due to this force, any object on the earth would be thrown into the space. However, the gravitational force is working towards the center of the earth at the same time. This force is many times greater than the centrifugal force. Hence, any object on the surface of Earth remains at the place where it exists. Tides. The following factors are responsible for the occurrence of tides. First one, the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun as well as that of the Earth. Second, revolution of the earth around the sun and the indirect revolution of the moon around the sun. Third, centrifugal force generated due to the rotation of the earth. The moon is closer to the earth than the sun. Hence, its gravitational force becomes more effective than that of the sun. Tides occur due to the relative position of the moon, the sun, and the earth. A place on the earth located at the opposite points of the place experiencing high or low tide also experiences high or low tide respectively at the same time. This is a result of the centrifugal force. See figure 3.6 and try to understand the location of high and low tides on the earth. First point, when there is a high tide at 0 degree meridian, the 180 degree meridian also experiences high tide. Second point, the meridians that are at right angles to those having high tide will experience low tide at the same time. If it is high tide at 0 degree and 180 degree meridians, then at which meridians will low tide occur? What can be the answer? Can you think? The answer is, a place on the earth located opposite to the place experiencing high or low tide also experiences high or low tide respectively at the same time. Therefore, if it is a high tide at 0 degree and 180 degree meridians, then it will be a low tide at 90 degree east and 90 degree west meridians. Think about it. Large rockets are used to go into the space away from the earth. Which force do they act against? Just we had discussed on it. You can give the answer. Yes, correct. Answer is large rockets which are used to go into the space away from the earth act against the gravitational force of the earth.
Types of tides. As the timing of the tide varies every day, the range of a tide also keeps on changing. Generally, the highest high tide occurs on full moon and new moon days, whereas on the days of the first and the third quarter, the high tide is at its minimum. Spring tides and neap tides are the two types of tides. Spring tide. On new moon and full moon days, the gravitational pull of the sun and the moon act in the same direction. Due to this, the total pull increases. Hence, the tide on these days is much higher than the average high tide. This is known as spring tide. See figure 3.7. As the bulge at the high tide is greater, the water or at low tide recedes much more. The water level during spring tide is higher than the average tide and lower than the average low tide. Neap tide. While revolving around the earth, the moon makes a right angle with respect to the earth and the sun twice a month. This position occurs on the first and the third quarter of each month. On both these days, the forces of both the sun and the moon operates at right angles on the earth. See figure 3.8. At the places where the sun causes high tide, the gravitational pull of the moon, which is at right angles, also act on the sea water. Due to such conditions, the water level rises is less than usual at the time of high tide.
Similarly, falling water level is less than usual at the time of low tide. This is because the attraction of the sun and the moon are not complementary but at right angles to each other. Such tides are called neap tides. Neap tides are a little lower than the average high tides and a little higher than the average low tides. Do you know? Intertidal range. The difference in the water level of the high tide and the low tide is called tidal range. In open seas, this range is about 30 cm. However, towards the coastal areas, it goes on increasing. Along the coast of peninsular Indian, the range is around 100 to 150 cm. For most of the part, the highest tidal range in the world is observed at Bay of Fundy, along the Atlantic coast of the North America. Here, the tidal range is about 1600 cm. In India, the highest tidal range is in the Gulf of Cambod. It is about 1100 cm. Effects of tides. With the high tide, fish move into the creeks and this helps fishing activity. The tides clear the waste and hence the coast becomes clean. Ports do not get filled with sediments. Ships can move up to the ports during high tide. During high tide, seawater can be stored in salt pans from which salt can be obtained. The tidal force can be used to generate electricity. A lack of an understanding of the timings of high and low tides may cause accidents to swimmers entering the sea. The tides help in maintaining the mangroves and the coastal biodiversity. Timings of the tides change daily. The tides are continuously occurring phenomena. After reaching the maximum water level during high tide, the low tide sets in. Similarly, after reaching the lowest water level during low tide, the high tide sets in. Remember that in the following discussion, the highest limit of the high tides is mentioned. See figure 3.9. You will understand why the timings of the high and the low tides change daily. There will be high tide at point P, as it is opposite to the moon, as point F is opposite to the point P. It will also experience high tide at the same time. It will take 24 hours for point P to come back to its original position. Point P will be at point F after 12 hours. The same change will also occur with reference to the point F. Point F will not experience the same high tide because in the meanwhile the moon also would have moved a little ahead. Hence, it will take 25 minutes more for the point F to come to the position opposite to the moon. After 12 hours, 25 minutes, F will arrive opposite to the moon and it will experience high tide. Point P opposite to F will experience high tide. Later again, after 12 hours and 25 minutes, point P1 will experience high tide as it comes in front of the moon. There will be high tide at F1, 2 as shown in the figure 3.9. There is high tide and low tide twice a day in 24 hours. Generally, the time difference between two high tides is of 12 hours and 25 minutes. Try this. Take a wide open large dish. Keep the dish on a table or a flat surface. Fill the water in the dish up to the rim. We have to generate waves in the dish. Is it possible to generate waves without touching or showing the dish? Try doing so. In what different ways can you generate waves in the dish? Yes, it is possible to generate waves without touching or showing the dish. We can generate waves by blowing air over the dish. Some of the methods by which waves can be generated in the dish without touching or showing the dish are as follows. By blowing air with mouth on the water. By blowing air with the help of paper fan. Geographical explanation. Waves. If you blow air over hot milk or tea while drinking, ripples are generated on the milk or the tea. In the same way, because of the force of the wind, water appears to be moving. The sea water gets pushed by the wind and ripples and generated on the water surface. These are called waves. The sea water moves up and down or slightly forward and backward due to the waves. The waves bring the energy contained in them to the coast. They break in the shallow waters near the coast. Large or small waves are formed continuously at the surface of the sea. Generation of waves is a natural and regular occurring phenomenon too. See figure 3.10. Structure of the waves. The sea water get pushed up and down because of the wind. The raised up portion of a wave is called crest and the depressed one is called trough. If a strong wind is blowing in one direction, large waves are generated. The vertical distance between a crest and the following trough is called the amplitude of the wave. whereas the distance between two successive crests or troughs is called wavelength. The wavelength, its amplitude and its velocity depend on the velocity of the wind. See figure 3.11. Velocity of waves. If we stand at the coast, we feel the waves are coming towards the coast. If a floating object is thrown at a distance in the sea, we find the object moving up and down at the same place. It does not come to the coast, it means the water forming the wave also does not come to the coast. Remember that the water in the waves does not move. What moves is the energy. The main reason of wave generation is wind. But at times, due to earthquakes or volcanic eruptions occurring below the floor of the sea, waves can generate it. Such waves assume a great height in the shallow waters near the coast. These waves are very destructive. They cause huge loss of property and life. These waves are called tsunami. In 2004, tsunami waves were generated because of the earthquake that took place near Sumatra Island of Indonesia. They devastated the east coast of India as well as of Sri Lanka. The waves cause erosion along the headlines and create beaches in the protected locations of the bays. Always remember, if earthquake occur in the ocean, the coastal areas face a risk of tsunami. In such cases, it is better to go away from the coast or towards higher altitudes. This way, loss of life can be avoided. Do you know while moving along the sea coast or playing in the water, we must take adequate care regarding the timings of the tides. Otherwise, it can lead to serious accidents. For that, we must know the timing of the tides. For this, you must know the phases of moon on the given day. 3/4 of the phase of moon is the time of the high tide. For example, suppose you are at the coast on the 4th phase of the moon. Then 3/4 of the phase is 3. It means the high tide will occur at 3 a.m. and 3 p.m. and approximately 6 hours from it, that is 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. will be the low tide. There may be slightly differences according to local conditions. We must collect the information from local people and learn from them about the structure of the coast. Its slope, rocky areas as well as the streams near the coast before entering the sea waters for enjoyment. Yeah.